What's going on, guys? I'm Fuller from Custom Offsets, Custom Offsets TV on the YouTube, and I don't usually make videos in my spare bedroom, but hopefully within the next couple of weeks here, we'll be back in the shop. So I wanted to talk to you guys a little bit today about the differences and the pros and cons between powder coating and painting. So I think most of you guys are familiar with both of those options, but might be kind of weighing out, you know, what's the differences between the two and why would I want one over the other? And that really kind of depends on what part of the vehicle you're talking about. So first things first, the differences between them. Now, paint, as you guys know, that's probably something you're familiar with. It's a liquid. It's a sprayable liquid. It's a wet application, so you have to obviously prep the surface firsthand, which, you know, entitles a lot of things. We're not going to go over every single step, but it's basically thoroughly cleaning, getting everything sanded down, doing any, you know, body work that might need to be done, and there's a lot of prep work that goes into then finally being able to paint it. But like I said, it's a sprayable liquid, so that's how that is applied. Now, powder coat is kind of exactly what it sounds like. It is actually a powder, but rather than being sprayed on wet, it's actually a dry process where that powder is basically electrostatically clung to whatever you're applying it to. And then it's with heat, that's when you can bake it on there, and then that actually gives you your final finish. Now you can go in and do clear over the top of it, and there's other stuff involved with powder coating as well, but those are the basic differences between the two. Now, paint, plenty of people tackle at home, especially if it's on smaller things, like if you're just doing emblems or, you know, small touch-up work, you can handle that paint process on your own. Now, if you want something automotive quality, you know, and like a final show quality finish, that's obviously going to be something that you want to bring it to a professional to do. Now, powder coating is kind of similar, but I don't know that there's very many people out there that are trying to do powder coat at home because the process just isn't quite easy as spray paint. Obviously, spray paint in a can is a little bit different than actually having a full paint booth and a spray gun set up and all of that, but you can do paint at home. Powder coat is just a whole nother beast because you need that large oven. So like, say you wanted to do your wheels. Now, if you wanna spray paint your wheels, or if you've got a small setup, you know, you can put your wheels out in the garage or whatever it is, get your spray gun out and paint those wheels, you can probably pull that off. Now, when it comes to powder coating, you need an oven that you can put those wheels into. So like I said, it's just a little bit more involved process, and you need a little bit more equipment, actually kind of a lot of bit more equipment, to do powder coating properly. So pros and cons between the two. A lot of people like paint because of its ability to be customized. And now you can customize powder too, but we'll get into that in a little bit. But as far as paint goes, there's a lot you can do to mix custom colors. You can mix different options, whether you're spraying it on metal or plastic to try to get those colors to match. Or if you have, you know, your stock color of your vehicle and you wanna paint match something else, you can literally paint match, because you can just keep tweaking the color and blending it a little bit different until whatever you're painting, say it, you know, be your lift kit or something like that, matches your truck perfectly. So that's a good option for paint if you want to match factory colors. With powder coating, you kind of have to go through a list of what's available for powder and then select whatever's closest. You might not get it exact, so it's not as precise. Now, it's not to say you can't do custom stuff with powder. You can add in different metal flakes, and you can do super chrome powder, or there's like lots of options out there as far as what colors you want to do or how metallic you want to get it, or if you want to end up with a satin finish or a matte finish. A lot of that is going to have to do with the clear that you put over whatever color you're doing, but there's options out there. Painting is really good if you want to do multiple colors, because you can put a tape line on there, spray it, and you'll be good to go. With powder, you can still do it, but it gets tricky, and not everybody is willing to do that. So powder is better suited for one color, or if you have something that's not necessarily just a tape line, if there's some sort of hard item that splits the difference between, you know, even if you can powder like the back half of your wheels and the front half of your wheels two different colors, that's an option too. Paint is going to be better for plastic items because you can't put plastic in an oven. It's going to melt. That one's pretty simple. As far as quality goes, with the right powder coater, you can get really, really good finish out of powder, just like you can get really, really crappy finish out of paint if you go with the wrong guy. So it really comes down to the shop. And I think one of the biggest complaints that we always hear about powder coating is that it's hard to find someone that does it right and does it, you know, with a decent turnaround time. We've went to a ton of different powder coaters for all the different trucks that we do. And it seems like each time we run into a couple, you know, minor problems with wherever place, there's always gonna be some sort of issue. We haven't yet found one person that does everything absolutely perfect, but there's guys out there that are close. So definitely don't just go to one place, you know, get your quote, drop it off and call it a day. Shop around a little bit and go to different places to explore what they're doing. A lot of the quality that comes with the powder coat, it has to do with their prep work as well. And if they're blasting the item before they're actually powder coating it, because some guys, if they're in a rush or doing it quickly, they're just gonna powder over whatever's there. And that's how you end up with, you know, cracked finishes and stuff like that. So definitely shop around, look for the best guy, try to get a look at their facility if you can, and you can really judge a lot of things just based off of how clean someone keeps their shop or how organized it is. Talking a little bit about that finish quality, if you want something that's got depth to it, that's where you're gonna need to go with paint, because the powder coat just doesn't have that depth. Now, like I talked a little bit about before, like the super chrome options, essentially you're like putting a layer of chrome down and then putting a color over the top of it. Chrome not necessarily being actual chrome plating, but a chrome styled powder coat, which does exist. Back in the day, they did a lot of wheels in a powder coated chrome. It was called PVD chrome, if you remember that. So there's options for you, and that gives it a little bit of depth. But if you want something super metallic, 3D looking, with a lot of depth on the paint that you can really buff up to really get it to shine, I think paint's a better option. Now, powder coat, the biggest advantage of powder coat is actually the durability that it has. So with paint, say you get a rock chip or something like that, or there's some sort of, I guess we'll go with a rock chip as an example. Rock impacts your wheel at a high rate of speed. That's gonna hit that paint, probably crack, might start peeling a little bit. That can happen with paint. Now with powder coat, the powder coat is significantly more durable. So you might, you know, still have a chip put into it, but it's not gonna, like, it's not gonna spider web out. You won't have pieces flaking off. It's only right where it hits. So there's that. Now with paint, you can touch it up. And with powder coat, you kind of need to refinish the whole item, whatever it is that you're powder coating. We're gonna use a wheel as an example. You'd wanna refinish basically that whole wheel, because you can't just do one section. It's best to do the whole thing. Whereas, like I said, with paint, you could touch it up a little bit if you needed to. When it comes to lift kits, that's another item that's really, really popular to get powder coated. And the only downfall here is that because powder coat is so much more durable, it's also significantly thicker. So when you're prepping the kit, if you're doing the prep work or whoever's prepping, you might want to just tell them, it's important that you plug the holes that are in the kit or the threads where your bolts are going to go in. Because if that gets powder coated, basically you've changed the diameter of some of the holes for the bolt to go through, and you might need to drill them back out, or the threads might need to be retapped because they're now full of powder. So that's something also to keep in mind. But those are kind of the big differences between paint and powder, so hopefully that helps you guys. I know a lot of people are looking for specific color wheels, or they're asked, do you guys have purple wheels? Do you have blue wheels? Do you have green wheels? And although some of those options are out there and you can search for them in the filter section on our website, if you want something custom colored, it's always best to have that done locally, because you can actually go there, see a sample or get a sample done, and see exactly what that color is going to look like, versus us, you know, guessing based off a picture what you roughly want it to look like and then getting them and having it be one shade off, which is probably more annoying than if it was, you know, a completely different color. So if you want to check out anything wheels, tire, suspension related, we got all that stuff on our website, but we wanted to at least get you guys some information on the stuff and kind of better educate you on the differences between paint and powder, and hopefully that helps influence your decision on your next set of wheels or on a lift kit or whatever it is that you want to paint or powder coat. Peace.